Now let's see the baggage rules of 2016. Now it says the old baggage rules were in 1998 have been substituted with the new baggage rules, which are later on amended also. The new rules aim to simplify and rationalize the multiple slabs of duty-free allowances for different categories. And the new rules have come into effect from 1/4/2016. So that was a part of history. Now come down to the new rules. The salient features are discussed here and now. First is the general duty-free baggage allowance. The general duty-free baggage allowance for different classes of passengers coming from different countries is given here under. So this is the first table you have to remember. General means for anyone who is coming into India. Rule number 3, class of passengers is Indian residents like you and me. We are Indian residents. We have gone out of India and then we are coming back. Okay. Then foreigner residing in India. Foreigners are there, but they are now residing in India. They are residents of India. They are working in India. They also have gone outside and then they are coming back to India. Or a tourist of Indian origin. Like all our NRIs who are of Indian origin, they might come to India as tourists. So these two people are returning and this person is coming as a tourist. Okay. Where are they coming from? Any country other than Nepal, Bhutan or Myanmar. Any country they are returning from except these three. Okay. Then they can bring duty-free, this is the duty-free allowance, used personal effects and travel souvenirs. Use personal effects like the clothes that we are using that we can bring and travel souvenirs. And articles means anything that you purchase and bring it up to a value of 50,000 rupees, excluding articles mentioned in Annexure 1. Means Annexure 1 articles are not allowed duty free in this 50,000 rupees. Even if they are valued at 10,000 or 20,000, they will be fully taxable. Write down Annexure 1 articles fully taxable. Other than an extra one, if you bring any other thing, then that will be entitled for exemption of 50,000. This 50,000 is per person. If carried on in person, means on yourself, like a jacket or something, or in the accompanied baggage of the passenger. Either you wear it or it is kept in your baggage. Then you are entitled for exemption of value up to 50,000 rupees. Okay. But here it is given excluding an infant. Means infant will not get this exemption. Okay. So this is the first category. Then second is tourist of foreign origin excluding infant. Tourist of foreign origin coming to India. Like all the foreigners who come to India as tourists. All foreigners coming to India as tourists. Again, other than Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar. They are coming from any country like US tourists coming to India, Brazilian tourists coming to India. Use personal effects and travel souvenirs fully exempt and articles up to 15,000 rupees only. Again, other than an extra one, if carried on the person or in the accompanied baggage of the passenger. So understood? First three categories, which includes us, Indian residents or foreign residents who are foreign people who are residing in India and tourists of Indian origin like NRIs. When these people come to India, they get 50,000 exemption. But if foreigners come to India on tourist visas, then they will get 15,000 exemption. Then Indian resident, rule 4, Indian residents or foreigner residing in India or tourists excluding infant, coming from Nepal, Bhutan or Myanmar. Coming from Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar. We can bring up to 15,000 rupees of goods. Other than an extra one again. If carried on person or in the accompanied baggage. And on arriving by land, only use personal effects. If you come from land route from these places, then only personal effects are allowed. No article of 15,000. Means if you come from land, then no exemption. This exemption is allowed only if you are coming from air or by ship.
Okay. Then, when a passenger is an infant, only used personal effects will be allowed duty free. In case of infants, only used personal effects. That's it. No goods. How can an infant buy goods? And another point, that these exemptions cannot be pooled. They cannot be pooled. Means if four family members have gone there and they are coming back, four family members have gone to Japan and they are coming back, can they pool their 50,000 exemption? Means if they have brought only one good, one TV that they have brought of 6 lakh rupees. So can they pool their exemption of 50,000, 50,000, 50,000 and 50,000 and claim exemption of 2 lakhs? No. Only one person will get one item. So if this is one item, one person can claim 50,000 exemption. That's it. It cannot be pooled. And who is an infant? Child who is less than 2 years is called as infant. Resident means holding a valid passport and normally residing in India. Tourist means a person not normally resident of India who enters India for a stay of not more than 6 months. Okay? Over 12 months period for legitimate non-immigrant purposes. Means he can come for medical tourism or for normal tourism. And personal effects means satisfying daily necessities but does not include jewelry. Personal effects does not include jewelry. Jewelry has a separate exemption. Okay? So, now if we analyze this point, the second point, that is Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, is to be checked. Huh? If Indian residents like we, all of us, foreigners who are residing in India and tourists, that is Indian tourists basically, when these people come from Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, then the exemption is allowed only up to 15,000 if you come by air or ship, and if you come by land route, then no goods exemption. It is only for personal used items, okay, and nothing else. So this has to be kept in mind. Then next is jewelry. Jewelry exemption is also given, but it is for passengers residing abroad for more than 1 year. So if you have been staying in Dubai for more than 1 year, means you are doing a job there or you have a business there and you are staying for more than 1 year and then you come back, then you can bring jewelry from any country. Gentleman means Farooq Haq will get exemption of 20 grams with a value of 50,000. Only I can bring 20 grams up to 50,000. Anything whichever is less, you can say. Like for example, if I am bringing 40 grams but the value is 40,000, then I will not get exemption of full 40,000. I will get exemption of only the value of 20 grams. Okay? So either in quantity or value, you have to check both, and exemption is whichever is less. So 20 grams up to 50,000. So second example is if I am bringing 15 grams only of gold but the value is 75,000. Then exemption will be restricted to 50,000. Okay, gentleman. And for lady, the lady passenger can bring up to 40 grams and value cap of 1 lakh. Ladies have got more exemption. So one was tourists coming to India, then second was jewelry, third is transfer of residence. If you transfer your residence back to India, so after becoming CA you went outside India, stayed there for 20 years and now you are coming back. You are transferring your residence back to India. This is called as TR in short. Then how much can you bring? So it says, will be allowed duty free clearance of articles on his return in the manner given in appendix below. This allowance would be in addition to, underline, in addition to the general exemption under rule 3-4. So the general exemption of 50,000 or 15,000 is available to you. Apart from that, you get this exemption. So this is in addition to, huh? So let's see that if you have stayed abroad for 3 months to 6 months, your duration of stay abroad is 3 months to 6 months. So you have gone, say, on a short visit, you had gone there for 5 months, and you are now coming back. Then personal and household articles. So your household articles also come, because you have set up a house there, so you might have some equipments for the house, so that you can bring. But other than appendix 1 and 2, an extra 1 and 2 articles cannot be brought, but an extra 3 articles can be brought, up to aggregate value of 60,000 rupees. Up to aggregate value of 60,000, you get exemption up to 60,000. Apart from that, general allowance of 50,000. So total exemption will become 60 plus 50, 1,10,000. And available to Indian passengers holding Indian passports. Second is from 6 months up to 1 year. If you stay more than 6 months up to 1 year, then the same thing, you can bring value up to 1,00,000. Again available to Indian passenger. And third category is 1 year during the preceding 2 years, minimum stay of 1 year during preceding 2 years. If you have stayed for 2 years, but in between you had been coming to India and then going back on vacations and all, but your stay should be minimum 1 year abroad during the past 2 years, then the value of exemption is 2,00,000. And available to Indian passenger who should not have availed this concession in the preceding 3 years. Means this exemption will be allowed after gap of every 3 years. Okay. Once you claim this exemption now, then you again go back, and after say 1.5 years staying for more than 1 year, you come back again. Can you get this exemption again? No. This exemption of 2,00,000 will be allowed in every intervals of 3 years. And then minimum stay of 2 years and more. If your stay is more than 2 years, then personal and household articles other than those and annexation 1 and 2, but including 3, up to 5,00,000. So if you stay for 2 years and more, then exemption goes up to 5,00,000. Condition is that minimum stay of 2 years abroad should be there immediately preceding the date of his arrival on TR. And here the shortfall of up to 2 months can be condoned by deputy or assistant commissioner if the early return is on account of terminal leave. So you had leaves with you and you took those leaves and came back. So you had 3 months leaves balance with you and you took those leaves and come back early. So then it's fine. Up to two months is condoned. Or any other special circumstance for reasons to be recorded in writing, like there was war in that country and hence you had to come back early, then it's fine. It is a special circumstance. So it can be condoned. Secondly, total stay in India on short visits during the 2 preceding years should not exceed 6 months. So within the last 2 years you have stayed in India on visits, but not more than 6 months. And this can also be condoned for special circumstances, like for example you had marriage ceremony or something and therefore you stayed for something more than 6 months. Fine. So PC or C may condone short visits in excess of 6 months for special circumstances to be recorded in writing. And third condition is passenger has not availed this concession in past 3 years. Again, so for this also you have to have at least 3 years gap for claiming exemption, and for this there is no relaxation. So it can be taken, this exemption of 5,00,000 can be taken after a gap of 3 years. All these have to be remembered, right? Question may come on any one of the points. Then another point is given, that currency will be governed by the foreign exchange management export import of currency regulations. That's fine, so no need to study that. Then unaccompanied baggage, it says the various provisions of the above rules are also applicable to unaccompanied baggage unless specifically excluded. If unaccompanied baggage has been in possession abroad of the passenger and is dispatched within 1 month of his arrival in India or such further period as the DCAC may allow. So it should come within 1 month gap, you can say. And the said unaccompanied baggage can also land in India up to 2 months before. So either you can send before or you can send it after. So before time is 2 months, after time is 1 month. However, if the passenger is not able to come to India within 2 months of the circumstance beyond his control, like sudden illness, like he has sent his baggage and he was going to come within 2 months, but he could not come because of illness, he was hospitalized, or any family member was hospitalized, or due to natural calamities, or disturbed conditions like war and all, disruption of transport or travel arrangements in the country due to heavy snowfall or something, the travel arrangements got disturbed. Then the DCAC may extend the time up to maximum 1 year for reasons to be recorded. And then crew baggage is also allowed here. So it says that these baggage rules are also applicable to members of the crew engaged in foreign going conveyance for importation of their baggage when they are finally paid off, means when they are terminated and they come to India, then they can also claim this exemption on termination of their engagement. And however, other crew members of a vessel aircraft will be allowed to bring free chocolates, cheese, cosmetics and other petty gifts item for their personal or family use for a value not exceeding 1500. Means every time they come, they go back and come back, so they can bring 1500 rupees every time. And then when they are terminated, then they can use that TR exemption as well. And family under these rules includes all persons who are residing in the same house and form part of the same domestic establishment. And goods listed under Annexure 1, 2 and 3 are given below. So this also you have to see. Annexure 1 is prohibited item. No exemption is allowed ever for Annexure 1. This includes firearms. You cannot bring it as a baggage exemption. Cartridges of firearms exceeding 50. Means if you are bringing gun, it will always be taxable. But if you already have a gun and you are bringing some bullets, then up to 50 bullets will be allowed exemption, but if it is beyond 50, not allowed. Cartridges, then cigarettes exceeding 100, or cigars exceeding 25, or tobacco exceeding 125 grams. So if you are bringing cigarettes, that is entitled for exemption, but only up to 100 sticks. Cigars only up to 25, and tobacco up to 125 grams. Then alcoholic liquor or wine in excess of 2 liters. So alcoholic liquor, if you are importing an old wine bottle from France, it will be entitled in 50,000, but only up to 2 liters. If it is more than 2 liters, then taxable. Then gold or silver in any form, other than ornaments, not allowed. And ornaments also not allowed here because they are considered as jewelry. So jewelry exemption is separate. And flat panel televisions. Televisions are not allowed under exemption. So the example that I gave was just an example for pooling. But in fact, that 50,000 exemption will not be allowed if it's a big TV. If it's a flat panel TV, then even 50,000 exemption will not be allowed. Then Annexure 2 is color television. Now this is not allowed under TR. This is for TR exceptions. Color television, which color television? Flat panel, normal TV, that old box TV that was there. Then video home theater system, dishwasher, domestic refrigerators of capacity above 300 liters. Above 300 liters means big fridge, deep freezers, video cameras, or the combination of such video camera with any one or more of the following, namely television receiver, sound recording and recording apparatus, and video producing apparatus. Is basically all video cameras, cinematographic film of 35 mm and above, and gold or silver in any form other than ornaments. So these are the exceptions of TR. In TR, you will not get exemption of 1 as well as 2. But if you are a normal passenger coming to India and you want to claim that 50,000 exemption, then Annexure 2 is allowed. Annexure 1 is not allowed. And Annexure 3 is also there. Video cassette recorders, players, digital disc players, music system, and all. You can read this once. And then it says the similar exemptions are also, amendments are also made in baggage declaration rules and so on and so forth. This you don't have to study. And this also don't have to study. Except that the rate, underline the rate of baggage is 35%. The rate of baggage is 35%, okay? So baggage is taxable at 35% flat rate. Whatever goods are there, after allowing the exemptions, whatever amount remains, it will be straight away taxed at the rate of 35%. However, this rate is not applicable to firearms, cartridges or firearms exceeding 50. 50 are entitled for exemption, but above 50 are taxable. And cigarettes and cigars and tobaccos in excess of the prescribed limits. Okay. And goods imported through courier service. If you import goods through courier, then this rate is not applicable. Then they will be taxable at the normal rates which are applicable to them as per the Customs Tariff Act. Then this notification is again not to be studied. And lastly, an example is given that Mr. Sujoy, an Indian entrepreneur, went to London to explore new business opportunities on 1/4/15. His wife also joined him in London after 3 months. The following details are submitted by them with the customs authorities on their return on 15/4/16, means more than 1 year has gone. Use personal effects of 80,000, two music systems each worth 50,000. So this will come as articles. The jewelry brought by Mr. Sujoy worth 48,000, 20 grams. And jewelry brought by his wife was 96,000 worth 40 grams. So wife has stayed for less than 12 months, less than 1 year. Husband has stayed for more than 1 year, wife has stayed for less than 1 year. So with reference to baggage rules, determine the exemption allowed and the duty payable. So it says, as per the rule 3, so on and so forth, shall be allowed clearance free of duty bona fide baggage, that is to say use personal effects and travel souvenirs and articles up to value of 50,000, right, if they are carried on passenger. Thus, there is no custom duty on used personal effects and travel souvenirs, and general duty-free exemption is 50,000. Thus, duty liability of Mr. Sujoy and wife is nil for the used personal effects of 80,000 and two music systems each worth 50, because one music system will be claimed by Sujoy and one by his wife, to 50-50, both become exempt. As per rule 5 baggage rule, the jewelry allowance is as follows. Then let's see what about jewelry. So this we have already seen, gentleman 20 gram up to 50 and lady 40 gram up to 1 lakh, but there is a condition of staying abroad for 1 year. Consequently, there is no duty liability on jewelry bought by Sujoy as he has stayed abroad for more than 1 year. So his exemption will be allowed. However, wife is not eligible for this exemption because she has stayed for less than 1 year. So her jewelry will be fully taxable. Okay. So that is how the baggage rules are there. You have to study it at least 4 times. And remember all the amounts, okay? Hence I am telling you 4 times, because you have to remember the amounts. It is not just logic, but it is also remembering. So you have to retain, okay, all the amounts. 50,000, 15,000 for jewelry, 50,000, 1 lakh as the case may be, and for TR, all the different figures that you have to remember by heart.